Hey guys, it's Matt from Eastwood. We're here doing another live tech session in the Eastwood garage. Let me turn this welder off so you guys can hear me. Today we're doing a little tech session walkthrough on one of our new welders that we've recently come out with. It's pretty cool. It is the Eastwood MP200i. If you're not familiar with this type of unit, this is a multi-processor unit that will do multiple, like it sounds, multiple processes. So you can do with this welder MIG welding, which I was just showing you, which is pretty cool. And you can also do TIG and stick, which is also awesome if you need to switch around, do different types of welding. It's pretty cool. Now, this unit is on our daily deals for the day. So if you hit the homepage, eastwood.com, of course, you can go on the homepage and you can see that this particular unit is 10% off and free shipping today. And if you put your order in, you can get this thing hopefully for Christmas time. So if you have any questions about this unit as far as pricing and everything else goes, we have Randy over here that does a lot of the live videos as well. He's answering your questions. If you have any questions about specs or other units or welding in general, he's going to answer them for you. If he has any questions that he feels is good for us to answer live on camera, he's going to throw them over my way. So my, I'll go over a little bit with the dials and gauges on this, and then I'm going to show you my favorite feature of this unit that what I think makes it a really, really, really handy unit to have. So on the front of this, I'm going to click it on. It's going to make a little noise, so I'll talk over it. It has a digital readout on the front, which is pretty cool. Some of our other units are analog. They're real basic, which is really nice. And they also have infinite adjustability, so there's not knobs that you click and you're stuck in settings. This unit is just the same way, but it takes it up a notch. The cool thing is that this unit, we can now adjust our wire speed and our voltage, our power, how much heat. We can adjust it and we can get it to the point of fractional voltage. So if I'm welding sheet metal or something that it's really crucial to have exactly the right power that I need, or you're welding thick to thin, and you really got to dial the welder in, you can go. Hopefully you guys can see this from where Joe's shot. I mean, you can see I can turn this and get fractional with, you know, just a little bit of a turn. So you can really dial this thing into where you want it. The other thing that I like is I like to write, we have our settings in the machines and in the instructions that we always include in here, which is great. This is a baseline that gets you pretty close when you're first starting to weld, but this isn't the Bible. You don't have to go exactly by everything that's in here. You may have to stray from those settings, but it'll get you close. What I like to do is, now that I have a number readout, a physical number, I can go and write these numbers down either inside my machine or just somewhere, you know, on my workbench. I can write down and I can remember the exact setting that I was using, so I can get the same exact weld every time when I'm welding whatever it is. So if you have to walk away, or say you have multiple projects and you have to change the settings on machine, or if you work in a shared space where your buddy or coworker may use this machine, you can write down your settings exactly what they were, because there's a digital readout and you're good to go. You can go back and you can start welding again, which is pretty cool. So like I said, you can adjust this just like this to exactly what you need. Where before I would just be like, eh, it was about 5.5. But actually it's, you know, it's 0.3. It's not actually really half quite yet. And then as we hit the trigger, we can change our wire speed and our readout as well. When you're welding with the stick welder or TIG welder, you can also change that, the settings over there, to dial them exactly where you want. The stick weld and the TIG welder on the machine, it is DC only. I'm sure that's probably a question we're gonna get. So you can weld just steel on that side with the TIG welder. But you can still do a ton of welding and fabrication. It's with the TIG welder and stick welder, it's 1/4 inch if I remember correctly. And I think it's 3/8 on the MIG welder. depending on the size of the wire that you run through the machine, that does change the output a little bit. And let's turn this here. So we have the other dial on here. This is the part that's my favorite. I'd probably, even if I had other machines in the shop, I'd probably have this machine just for this feature because it's so darn cool. The other really cool feature on this is we've added a spot timer on this. We know a lot of you guys that are following Eastwood products and are great customers of ours. You're doing automotive stuff. And with automotive work, a lot of times you're replicating spot welds or you're doing stitch welds where you're overlapping and you're just zapping the trigger. If you want to get, really, really smooth spot welds that look the same every time, this is the way to do it. You can dial the machine in, and now all you have to do is hit the trigger once and hold it in, and it's going to weld for you and then stop. So you can really dial your machine in just how you want to get the spot weld or stitch weld that you want, and then all you have to do is just hit the trigger over and over again, and you don't have that extra stumbling point that you might hold the trigger too long or something like that that could change your weld and cause you to blow through. So I wanted to show that today because I think that's pretty cool. It's my favorite thing. I also forgot to mention this does have a port here where you can do on steel. You can throw one of these spool guns in and you can do aluminum welding with the machine. It's pretty simple. You just fish the cord through, plug it in, and you're ready to go. So let's get set up with the spot timer. I got a piece of sheet metal I drug out just to show you guys, because I want to kind of show you how to dial this in real good. Do we have any questions? I imagine they're pretty straightforward today.
Yeah, there's no real difficult questions yet.
No problem.
So a few people just giving shout outs, I guess, that are always watching us.
Oh, cool. So,
and don't forget tomorrow at 2:00, our huge, like 2-hour, you'll get to see Matt doing an English wheel, shrinker stretcher maybe, hammer and dollies from 2 to 4:00 tomorrow afternoon. Plus we're going to cover powder coating, welding, I think what else, underhood light. It's like 20 some products.
Like pretty much all our favorite products. We're going to do we've been doing well with this live thing, so we're going to try a little marathon, if you will. You can call in. You can call Joe's cell phone and talk to him directly. That's an idea, at least. We don't know if it's going to happen, but. All right, so spot timer. I got it set here. I'm gonna mess up my DAWs a little bit because I had it dialed in kind of where I wanted it. So I want to get it back to, we're going to work our way from there. So I just kind of hit the dials. I got the spot timer on. So if you didn't see, I had it turned a little bit. It's a little switch here. We could switch it on to spot timer. And then down here, of course, is the dial where we can adjust this dial to get the amount of time that it's actually going to be spot welding. So you need to hit the trigger once, like you would normally to initiate the arc, and hold the trigger down the entire time. And it will weld until until the timer's over, and it will stop. So I'm going to change these dials and see how it changes, and I'm going to dial it in on this piece of 20 gauge here to get a nice flat spot weld. So I'm going to hit the trigger once and just hold it. Way too long. In fact, it practically welded it to the table. So I had the power turned up pretty high, and it's a big fat, that's not, if we were doing sheet metal work, that's not a spot weld that I want. But that's okay, we got a scrap piece that's the same thickness of what we're working on, no big deal. That's why you do it on the scrap piece and not on your project car. So now I got that. We know it's way too hot because I'm burning through and it was welding for far too long. Now when I do spot welds, I like them to be hot and quick so you can get in and out. So I'm going to not turn it down very much on the voltage side here, the power. I'm going to turn it down maybe one volt or so. But I'm gonna turn the spot timer. I had it way up, so I'm gonna turn it down there. Just a little over. So I probably cut the spot timer in half here. Let's listen to what it sounds like, the length of time. Much shorter, all right? We're gonna show you that one. So you can see already just the difference in the size of the weld. It's getting smaller, getting closer to what we want. But now this probably, the only reason this probably isn't falling through here is because I have it flat on the table, so the table's kind of soaking up some of the heat. But if this was on a vehicle, you'd get something like these ones I was doing yesterday that are burning all the way through if it's not supported on the bottom. So we could tell just by that weld, that's probably a little too big and still a little, but I like the temperature. I thought it was pretty good. I'm gonna maybe turn it down just a tiny bit, but I'm gonna still turn this spot timer down pretty low. Now you'll really start to hear how short of a weld. Oop. Not getting a good ground there. So I have it on the table just so it's out of the way, but we'll put it right on the piece now. How much shorter that was, I turned it way down. That's probably a little too short. That's actually not. This is what I do every time I work on, I set the machine up. So see the difference in the spot weld between these. I mean, these are, you're just burning and heating up so much material. And if you're doing a spot weld, generally the hole that you're welding up or a plug weld shouldn't be that big. I mean, that's just filling a crater. So if you look on the back side of the panel here, you got pretty good penetration on that. I'm actually pretty happy with that. So I'm going to, I turned it up just a little bit for the spot timer just to go a little longer. But that's pretty close. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to check this one more time, and then we'll do a bunch of them real quick in a row, and you can hear how we're getting the same pretty much consistent spot weld over and over. Let me just check this one real quick. All right, so that I turned it up there. Now when you start getting it down in these low spot timer down real low, you can see the difference, just that little tap of the dial I did. So I think that's a little big. I'm a little picky when it comes to these. I'm gonna turn it down just a hair. I'm gonna leave our amperage or our voltage the same on this, our power. Clamp it, and let's do one more test, and I'm gonna run a line of these and you guys can listen. Always cut your wire. All right, that's pretty good. That's kind of, so you can see we're getting full penetration there through the panel. So that way, there you go. So if this machine has the power that if you don't want to drill a hole in the top piece to do like a plug weld, and you want to do like a true, not a resistant spot weld, but like a true spot weld, we're welding through the top layer and into the bottom layer. About where I'm at could probably get us there. I could probably turn the spot timer up just a tiny bit more, and we could zap these two panels overlap together without even drilling a hole. It's got the power. And if you get your machine set right, you can do it every time. So I'm gonna work across the panel here. Now I got it set up and you guys can listen. I'm not that good that I can hit the trigger every time exactly the same. So be able to hear how. See, here it's the same every time. Now, the one trick, I guess I could say, is generally you should cut the little ball that forms on the end of the wire off, and then start your weld again. That's why that one I had, it caught up on me a little bit, or it didn't arc right away for me. If you are quick enough that you can leave that little red, the ball's still kind of glowing on the end there, you can keep going having to cut the piece if you're trying to move along like that. If this is a panel that's anywhere on the exterior of the car that I don't want to warp, I would never do that many in a row. That would just start putting too much heat into the panel. But what I want to show you guys is the consistency. Look at the size of the spot welds. They're all basically the same. Any difference in the center of these welds is probably just the angle of my torch a little bit. I might have had my torch turned up a little bit more on one than the other. But you can get, you know, they look almost exactly the same, which is great. You can see we're getting, you know, if this, depending on what I was doing, if we were drilling an access, a plug weld where I had a hole in this one and I was welding the next one, I'd actually probably turn the heat down a little bit. But you can see if we were just butting the two of them together and welding them with no hole drilled, we're getting 100% penetration there where it would melt through, over 100%, and would melt through into the next piece and weld the two of them together, which is great. So that's my favorite feature on this machine. On top of that, of course, it is with the multi-process machine, you can use this machine on a generator. If you need to go out on a remote situation, whether you on your property or if you're a race car at the track or something like that, you can use this machine. It is capable of working on, it can work with the fluctuating output of a generator without a problem. Some of the transformer units, you have to be careful. They either won't work or it may damage the machine, which is no good. So, but for me, for automotive use, which is mainly what I do, that spot timer is a lifesaver. It's awesome. And it's great. So any other questions? That was my favorite thing. I just wanted to show that off on this morning for you guys.
We had a lot of questions, but they're pretty easy to answer today.
Cool. So. All right, guys. Well, that's the spot timer on the MP200i. Don't forget, it is our daily deal for the day today. So we're putting it up just for today. You can get 10% off and free shipping. You just hit eastwood.com, no special codes. It's right there on the homepage in front of you. And you guys can buy it, get a good deal, and save yourself a bunch of money. So thanks, guys, for watching. I'll catch you guys next time.